Hello and welcome to the 100th episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. I'm going to make this an extra long episode. I have no idea if I'm even halfway done with this game. I know it's taking me longer because I'm reading everything. That's what I do. And exploring everything and doing every quest possible.
Eyes open.
I guess
sure.
We're going to end up fighting more of these things, so I'm going to make this a hour-long episode. Something like that. Oh, we can level up Thiadess. Bong. Why does she look so green? She looks green. I remember her looking green. Let's take athletics for combat. That's it. 1 point to make us rank 6. Okay, we got level 4 powers here. Body attunement. Decipher probes the mind and soul of the enemy target, finding the strengths of its defenses and stealing them for his or her own. Drains a portion of the target's damage reduction, granting the same amount as a bonus to Decipher. That's pretty sweet. Plus 7 damage reduction stolen versus fortitude. Oh, I got 2 I can do. Mind Lance. Impales the target with a lance of pure force, inflicting major pierce damage to all in the line of attack with a high chance of causing an interrupt. Pain block. Provides an ally with a mental block on his or her pain, granting a bonus to their damage reduction and regenerating endurance over time. Only 11.5 endurance, though. Silent Scream. Produces a psychic howl in targeted areas, stunning the target as well as dealing raw damage to all enemies within. Stands a high chance of causing an interrupt. Nice. I like it. raw. Stunned for basically 8 seconds versus Will. And then foe AoE, Sam. Well, they get a will save against this raw damage. The target does not. He saves against the stunned effect. Pretty cool. Wild Leech. Latches onto some characteristic of the target's psyche and grants it... Sorry, drains it, granting the same amount as a bonus to the cipher. Affects a random attribute. 10 points stolen from a random attribute versus will. That's not very useful, being a random attribute. How about silent scream? That's pretty cool. That's a new sound. Okay, so I'm taking Ectopsychic Echo. Generates a rebounding wave of psychic feedback between a cipher and an ally that causes crush damage to anyone caught in between. Pretty cool. And Silent Scream. Ta-da! No new talent unlocks. Now that we're done with that, we were all basically around the same amount of points, so the rest are going to level up shortly as well. attack.
It
moves slow, at least. Not sure, because that moves. And we got three left, or one? Of those dots. Wait. Yeah. There's only one of them, so... Ooh! Damn!
Following your lead.
Can't pass up on that vessel flash there. Is this one... There was a... He left. There was a patient there. What's his name's in here? If he's still here, we can question him, yes. Everyone draw close in case he suddenly attacks. What have you done? Oh, we're gonna leave? I don't have time for this? There'll be some time before things calm down here. Oh, I wanna accuse him and tell him what we saw. Oh, wicks are loose. Are there more?
Rave thou philosophy.
I'm ready.
Oh boy. Oh my god, chunkage.
No problem.
Raved of Philosophy.
Hey, hey, someone else is ready to... Who else? I thought I heard that gong that someone was ready to level up. Disappointing. They killed the guard? Killing your flesh constructs. So there it is. Like animats, flesh constructs are created by animancers empowered by a captive soul. Unlike animats, they are not dependent on the will and loyalty of the bound soul. Flesh constructs, therefore, cannot be undone in doubt, but they are only capable of following simple instructions. Or by doubt. In doubt, is it? They also tend to be shorter-lived than animats, whereas the energy and faith in an animat soul can sustain it for decades, even centuries. The soul bound to a flesh construct will gradually fade away from its physical form, and the body will eventually stop responding to the soul's energy. Opponents of animancy in general and soul constructs in particular see this as a soul's rejection of an improper body and as evidence that flesh constructs are an abomination. Even among animancers, the creation of flesh constructs is controversial. Some see the process as a soul lobotomy and believe that a soul should be allowed to pass on to the next life rather than be used as mindless fuel for a body. Yeah, I agree with that. Oh, the wicks are loose. How'd they get out? Look how fast we kill these things. So there's nothing to loot there, okay. Yeah. So how does this tie into that opening and them getting out?
Following your lead.
Silver.
Got it.
Well, we can go in here.
And what does the flame reveal?
I'm not sure if we should even bother sneaking. I mean, these things are so easy, but who knows? We might come across like 10 of these constructs at once or something. Well, that's it for this room. Alright, they all came out, is what it is. Scroll of Rolling Flame creates a rebounding ball of fire, inflicting burn damage upon anyone in its path. 20 to 30 burn versus reflex. He's full, so I've been giving her the stuff. The goods. Let's look for secrets. Any secrets in here? Seems like it was made to have a secret put in it. Couldn't open the door to begin with. No, I guess not. We can't get through from here. We have to go around. Well, well. Where's this Orlin? Well, that's interesting. His laboratory is right on the other side of everything. Of his office. Let me just check in here. Okay. See if Modred's here still. See if he knows anything about all this. The head warden must be told what's going on down here. So tell him. I'm getting out of here. It's not safe anymore. She's still busy. Too funny. So, how about them wicks, huh? So the head warden Ethelmore says, "What the blaze has happened down there? You were given permission to ask questions." It's complicated. A patient of yours, Uskrim, was working for the Leaden Key, only without knowing it. You finish your explanation, and Ethelmore breaks his silence. I have read accounts of people in history who could do what you describe. The accounts are few and brief, and never reliable. Some go as far to suggest they are all the same person. If truly such a person were here among us, plotting our ruin, would that I had a body again and could be of some real use in our time of need. I fear what the future may hold for this place. I am grateful you were able to dispatch the threat before there was loss of innocent life. We very nearly had another scandal on our hands. What of Azo? What part did his experiments play in the catastrophe? Right. The Leaden Key would have found a way to interfere with the sanitarium even without Azo. Your half answer suggests a bias, but it also suggests it's as close to truth I'll ever get from you. No, it's true, man. Cadman will remain here, but he will be monitored, and under no circumstances will he have access to any equipment.
How do you do?
Alright, I guess that's it for him. Make sure no one has anything new to say before we get out of here.
Good day to you.
Alright, that's it. Oh, he does. It's him. It's Kenna. Gonna level up. I find athletics to be very useful. Alright, we can choose another phrase. Plus 10 defense against frightened attacks. These are good against terrified and frightened stuff. Sure-handed. Let's take this one. One doesn't stood against the power of the saint. Decreases the duration and defends against frightened and terrified effects for allies in the area of effect. Bonk. Done. Alright, let's get the hell out of here then. I don't know what we have to do next with this quest. Alright, we need to go to Heritage Hill. Twin Elms. And Slug's Compass. We got our butts handed to us there. We'll go back eventually. Far from home. Oh, that's going nowhere. Travel to a cave. Cliffs are so in the vision. Endless paths. Continue to get to know Durance. Hooray. I have to make my reputation stronger. Which I'm not sure how that'll happen after the incident and that library type place. Yeah, they all try to kill us. And the Anslug's Compass. Okay. Actually, let's just... See... We're overwhelmingly good champion in Gilded Vale. Unfortunately, Defiance Bay, we're now eccentric. So I think we have to do more good for a little while. I guess I can get the Heritage Hill. I know I can get the Heritage Hill from Andra's Gift, so let's go to Andra's Gift. Which is that way. Oh, who's coming? Someone's coming. Dunreed Row Messenger. Beg your pardon, I have a message for you. You are summoned to Hadra House, where Lady Webb wishes to meet with you as soon as possible. Ayla says, they say she's an ancient spider spinning her nets throughout the city. He gives you a careful look. If she wishes to see you, that either bodes very well or very ill. Tell me about Lady Webb. Do you not know Lady Webb? She's, well, no one's seen her exactly in a long time, but she's the mistress of Dunreed Row, has been for as long as anyone can remember. He pauses, eyeing passers-by with suspicion. Quietly, he continues, she's supposed to be old, older than anybody, and she never leaves her room. Some say she's wasted away and she's just a pile of bones kept animated by dark magics. She's still at it, best anyone can tell. Learning things, keeping us safe, pulling the strings behind a throne, too, it's sad. Has a ring of ciphers doing her bidding, telling her everything that goes on. You do wrong in this country, before you go asking the gods for forgiveness, best you ask Lady Webb first. What's Dunreed Row? A whole mess of ciphers run out of Hadred House. They make it their business to keep the peace, but they don't like you to see them do it. Problems in this city have a way of going away on their own, and when that happens, you can make a pretty good guess as to why. How did you know where to find me? Well, it's Lady Webb. She knows everything. I know this already. Where can I find Hadred House? It's just over there, my lady. The southwest corner of Brackenbury. Very well. I've been instructed to answer any questions you might have. Well, you've done so. Thank you. Interesting. Okay, every time we go to Heritage Hill, we get distracted somehow. Oh! It's that guy again. The robed man. Or is another robed man. As you near the apparition, you are overcome suddenly by a powerful anxiety that sits like a stone in your stomach. The feeling is not quite real, the recollection of an emotion rather than the emotion itself. It wrenches your insides nevertheless. The apparition's brow is tensed, a look of concern playing across its face. Okay, we're just running into everyone lately.
The other missionaries say you have been neglectful of your duties.
What are you supposed to be doing? What duties? Is he talking about the main quest? My mind has been elsewhere.
Oh? And what troubles you?
The apparition raises its eyebrows. The pain in your stomach deepens, and you feel, for a moment, as though you're about to be sick. Your mouth has gone dry. Forgive me, Eminence. I wish to leave the Order. I do? The man folds his fingers together and presses them to his mouth, thoughtful.
You have been an apt student, and your convictions have inspired those around you. May I ask what has changed to make you feel this way?
I'm confused about this whole thing. Is this the Order of the Watchers? Convert. I have no idea what answer is the correct one. Oh, we were attacked on my last mission. The apparition exhales slowly, and its lips press together, a sympathetic rapport in its eyes. It places its hand on your shoulder. It can do that? It's an apparition.
You feel you were responsible for this?
Other missionaries were badly hurt because of my decisions. Some will never be the same. The apparition gives a solemn nod. I was waiting for it to talk. Ours is not an easy calling. People are frightened by new beliefs. They sometimes react with violence. These are the risks we all assume when we take the oath. I put them at risk. I made the wrong choice.
If you approached the heathens because you believed it was what the gods would want you to do, then there was no mistake, and you bear no guilt.
How can that be?
The gods gave us many gifts, but clairvoyance was not among them. They do not judge our actions by their outcomes. They judge them by our reasons. Act out of love for the gods, and you can never be wrong in their sight. This was a tragedy you went through, and it will never leave your memory. But you needn't let it burden your soul as well. Leave judgment to the gods.
Will you stay with us? Finish what you started? The knot in your stomach seems to loosen all at once, and the anxiety is replaced with something else entirely, something warm and soothing, and it is something you know you can never repay. As the vision fades, you start to become cognizant of the many odd looks aimed in your direction. Your last response echoes in your mind. Yeah, they can't see him. I will. Alright, guys, let's continue forward here. Have we talked to her? I probably saw her soul already. Let's just go on to Hadron House. Let's see what this Madam Webb has once. Curran's wasting his time with those disappearances. Lady Webb is in charge of Hadron House, but she rarely deals with anyone personally. I guess we're the lucky ones. There are no secrets in Defiance Bay, not while we're around.
Good day, stranger.
Do you have anything else to say to Curran? I think we have to head upstairs. Let me just check in here really quick. I don't remember what's in here, who's in here. Let's go upstairs. Lady Webb, we'll see you now. she will see us now, okay? Lady Webb! In the vessel flesh, the notes are scribbled in a cryptic... What is it? Chiryptic shorthand. Mm-hmm. This would be the quarters of the web. I'm not gonna take that.
It's a simple test.
No, you can't do that. I don't wanna get in trouble anyway. This woman clutches a thick stack of parchment with spindly, wrinkled fingers, their flesh stretched thin to near translucence with extreme age. A gossamer veil over pale blue veins. Ink splotches and candle burns and the scars of innumerable slices from the edges of scrolls dot and stripe her hands like a quilt pattern after some great indescribable truth. Talk about paper cuts. She does not look up from her reading.
So, the messenger conveyed my summons. A miracle that would make the reincarnation of Aethys look like a child's cantrip, surely. It doesn't draw the most inspired minds, messaging. They failed me so many times of late, I nearly sent a cipher after you instead. So this is the Watcher who took over Cad Noir. Oh, don't look so surprised. It isn't an attractive expression.
Thanks.
I wouldn't be where I am for long if I let details like that escape me.
Kinda leans in toward you. A meager trick, given Cad Noir's fame.
And this fiasco in the sanitarium that you seem to have gotten yourself into the middle of. What in blazes possessed you to stir that nest of trouble?
There's someone I need to find.
Not just any someone, though. Someone in the service of the Leaden Key.
Ding, ding, ding. What do we have for her, Johnny?
You're not the only one with an interest in their recent activities. I've lost 4 ciphers this year alone trying to get someone inside their ranks. As it is, we only have our suspicions about who is in the group and what they intend. Which I suppose means we have much in common with them. I asked you here because I wanted to know what your interest was in all of this. I thought perhaps we might help each other. Why are you looking for the Leaden Key?
Should we be telling her about the soul and this awakening? She really knows I'm a watcher. I ran across a man in one of the ruins. It's important that I find him again. She closes her eyes and the lids flicker. Then her face goes still, and her mouth parts, little more than a sliver, and her hand briefly drops open, spilling some of her parchment to the ground, the pages wafting around her leg like the leaves of a dying tree. Her fleshy eyelids peel back, and her gaze is immediately upon you. She's reading our mind or something.
The gods are cruel, I'm afraid. The man you seek is Theos Ix Arcanon, Grand Master of the Leaden Key. One of the most elusive and dangerous men Eora has ever known.
How do you know I seek Theos? Thanos.
Because you have seen his face, and that makes it a simple matter for me to see it. You even happened to catch him in his ceremonial garb, it seems. It must have been a special occasion.
What can you tell me about Theos?
More than most, though very few would know so much as his name. And there is no way of knowing how much of what I've read is true. The Leaden Key dates back more than 2,000 years. If rumors are to be believed, Theos was the one who created it. What scraps of evidence exist suggest that he has died many times, only to be reborn each time exactly the same man. Awakened during adolescence with all the knowledge and experience of all his lifetimes. The plots he orchestrates sometimes take hundreds of years to bear fruit. Needless to say, this is not the natural order of things. But he is said to be one of Whittaker's favored, and that old bat was never one to let rules get in the way of favoritism.
Calling Whittaker an old bat?
That may also explain another supposed gift of his. His body is no boundary to his soul, and he is known to take possession of others, if their souls are weak enough. Often it is for elaborate deceptions, but sometimes he simply forces them to kill themselves. He is not known for his generous supply of pity.
Yeah, we've seen that.
He is also not one to show himself in any but their most critical matters. If he has directly involved himself in whatever the group plots now, it may be your only chance to find him. And once you do find him, if you can find him, I would not hold my hopes too high if I were you. He is a driven, single-minded man. He will not have the slightest concern for your problems.
How do you know so much about Thiadess?
The same way I come by all my knowledge. Exhaustive research, spying, bribery, perhaps some less savory measures. Whatever the knowledge demands, I pay in full. There is nothing of greater value. Unfortunately, with Thiadess, there is also nothing more scarce. He has covered his tracks far too well. His manipulations of the course of history are lost to time now, though I believe they were many.
What else is there to know about the Leaden Key?
Precious little, I'm afraid. You may know much of it already. No one member knows the identity of more than a handful of other members. They are kept in the dark of missions they are not involved in, or sometimes of those they are involved in. They exist to hide secrets they themselves don't know. If you can imagine how gullible someone must be for that to appeal. Despite that, they are very good at what they do, owing much to their founder, who will take matters into his own hands when necessary. And he does not fail.
What do you want from me?
Keep me informed. The Leaden Key has been busy lately, and that is distressing news. I can only guess as to what they intend. You seem to have a knack for turning the stones they've crawled beneath. Keep turning them. Dunreed Row will not stop you.
That's one way of putting it. Whatever it is they're up to, figuring it out will be of great use to both of us. In your case, it will surely point you to Thiadess. In return, I will share our knowledge with you as we learn it, and provide you with what assistance I can. And if I refuse? Then you would look foolish because it is a standing offer. There is no need to refuse.
If you find your trail has run cold, come to me with whatever you have. There is much I may be able to do for you.
There is something I can tell you about the Leaden Key's operations.
Well, let's hear it.
I found Thiadess in Brackenbury Sanitarium impersonating a patient. He was trying to damage the public's opinion of animancy. I guess that would be his, motive.
Forgive me. It is unlike Thiadess to leave witnesses. He must be furious.
Her eyebrows raised, two painted lines over barren, sloughing skin. Her forehead a lattice of wrinkles upon wrinkles. The corner of her mouth perks.
He did not aid you as you'd hoped, I take it? Well, take heart. With any luck, when he has finished his business, he will surely come and find you again, if only to kill you while you sleep.
Okay, take heart? That's not encouraging.
This news of yours makes sense, of course. To dabble in animancy is to puzzle over the secrets of the gods. This would not be the Leaden Key's first action against it. But if this is connected to their other activities, we may be in for something on a much larger scale. If we can learn more about their goals and methods, perhaps we can get the palace behind us. With Avar's support, we may be able to put a stop to this.
That's all? This progress is encouraging. I only hope that we are not too late. I have other questions.
Yes?
Is there, Lord Webb. Tell me more about Dunreed Row. All the things there are to know in this world, and you ask me about work. She shakes her head irritably. Deerwood is a rebel country. Conflict is in its blood. If you think a few guards posted in our cities keep chaos at bay, you are very new to town indeed.
We are Deerwood's cipher investigators, of course. But what we really are is its last barrier against anarchy. People are more at ease when they believe they are watched over by someone more enlightened than they are. It pacifies them. So that is the image we foster. And we do try to be enlightened for their sake. The knowledge we gather here is Deerwood's standing army in many ways. We learn what's vital and we act on it while Deerwood sleeps, blissfully unaware of the terrifying truths all around them. I wish I could tell people the things I know sometimes, but the truth is I don't think many of them could bear it.
Hmm. How did you come to be here?
Me? I started this place, in a different time, under a different duke. I impressed the duke with my research and my work ethic, and he became possessed of the notion that I would be ideal to lead a secret network of gifted investigators. I don't know how such an idea got into his head.
Wink. How old are you? She gives a half-hearted gasp and covers her mouth with her fingers. You wicked woman, where are your manners? Were you raised without a shred of decency?
I lost count ages ago. Such a strange thing to celebrate, getting closer to death. Oh, I've had my share of work done to prolong my existence, if that's what you're wondering. I'm not ashamed of it. I'm not done here. There are things I still wish to learn. And I'll be the effigy if I let Bereth carry me off before I'm through. There was a time when I considered enlisting the theorems of Pondgrum to extend my life indefinitely. I found the thought of devouring my political enemies to sustain my own life greatly appealing. I must have gone soft with age.
This is a really stupid question. Are you psychic?
If you are hoping I can look at your hand and tell you whom you should marry, you can just wipe that notion from your mind. I do not know what will happen tomorrow. That is what I pay spies for. Being a cipher is not unlike being a watcher. You notice more about what is already there.
I didn't mean fortune-telling. I was talking about telepathy. Many can hold an object and know where it's been, or peer into the thoughts of people around them. They can also sometimes affect those thoughts, but that would be unethical, of course. She cocks a painted eyebrow. A tiny, talented few pick up so much about the world around them, they can get images of things to come, but these are fleeting and unreliable. You said you don't know what will happen tomorrow.
Who said I was talented? I don't. Least not that I can trust. And with me, it's only ever about one thing anyway.
What's that?
A quiet day at home.
She glances back behind her toward a small table and a queer smile finds its way across her face. Why the small table? Is there a Lord Webb?
There was.
What happened to him?
He believed in dying with dignity. He was old-fashioned that way, my husband. We saw the world very differently, he and I. But he was good to me while he lasted.
So that's something else? Other questions?
Yes.
All right, farewell.
Try your best not to die out there.
Thanks. No, she's seen me.
Hey.
Hey.
All right, then.
Not just you, everybody.
Got it.
Okay. Now, unless we're going to run across somebody else. Let's head for Andra's gift. And from there, Heritage Hill. We could explore for a little bit. In 20 minutes or so. And that will probably be it for this huge anniversary episode. I'm already wondering if we're going to make it to 200 episodes. That'd be insane. Then that will be my second longest LP after Skyrim.
I often dreamed of visiting the Republics. There, at least, the people value trade.
Trade of all things, it's true. And competition between the Republics keeps us strong.
Rauatai is a unified nation, with fleeter ships. Someday it may prove a worthy competitor.
There's more to dominating trade than fast ships. Maybe you could write a poem to help your countrymen figure it out.
I remember that conversation. Oh, we can level people up. Aloth and Palagina. Giving everybody athletics right now. You really don't need people to be... I mean, the stealth of the party will be whoever's the most stealthiest. And the lore as well. Mechanics, I mean, you only need one person to be disarming traps and stuff. So I'm going to save the rest of the points. Ooh, spells. Fourth level. Delirium. Dimensional shift. Oh, it can be two! Switches the locations of the caster and one ally, leaving a shockwave between them that stuns all caught in a line of fire. Pretty cool. That's similar to that spell that we just gave Thiadess. Essential Phantom. Creates a ghostly double of the caster, causing shock damage to enemies hit by it. Summon a lost duplicate. I like it. Flame shield. See that though? Engulfs the caster in fire, increasing their freeze damage reduction and causing burn damage to anyone who damages them with a melee attack. That's pretty cool. Iron skin. Oh, lasts for up to 10 attacks, plus 8 damage reduction until damaged. Concussive missiles. 5 missiles of pure force. -27 crush on the main target and 11-16 on the other ones. Minor Arcane Reflection creates a field of arcane energy around the caster, causing hostile target spells to be reflected up to third level to be reflected back to their casters. Minor Grimoire Imprint gives the caster access to one free spell from the target wizard's grimoire, allowing them to cast a spell of third level or lower that is not currently in that grimoire. That's cool. Wall of Flame. Generates a fearsome vertical sheet of flame, inflicting burn damage to anyone moving through it. Okay. I can see that being problematic, though. Confusion. I mean, picturing people with ranged attacks and but them having to move forward and moving into the fire, I'd have to know exactly where to put this fire, so let me just not take that for now. I definitely want to take iron skin. And concussive missiles. Done. And now Palagina. Her athletics is awesome. Look at that. Give her a survival. There we go. We can take an ability. Inspiring Triumph. Inspires all allies in the vicinity when the paladin downs an enemy, providing a temporary bonus to all defenses. Cool. Liberating Exhortation. Commands an ally to summon all their strength in order to temporarily ignore existing hostile effects. The effects will resume once Liberating Exhortation ends. Friendly target, hostile effects suspended for 23 seconds. Pretty cool. Zealous Charge. Inspires the paladin and all nearby allies to charge fiercely into battle, increasing their movement speed and disengagement defense. Cannot be active with other zealous auras. Sworn Enemy. Marks an enemy as the focus of the paladin's righteous fury, granting accuracy and damage bonuses against the target until combat ends or the target goes down. 3 per rest. Oh, cool. Plus 15 accuracy against marked targets and plus 20% damage. I like that. Deprive the Unworthy. The paladin temporarily snuffs out all active beneficial effects on a single foe. The effects resume once Deprive the Unworthy ends. It's only for 23 seconds. Zealous Endurance. Fills the paladin and his or her allies with unshakable confidence, increasing their damage reduction and converting a portion of incoming hits to grazes. Cannot be active with other zealous auras. Reviving Exhortation. Commands an unconscious ally to get back up, giving a large but temporary spike to endurance, some of which is lost after a short duration. 1 per encounter. Target revive with 318 endurance. And then minus 53. I like that. If I can choose another one, I'll probably choose that. Three per rest. 1 per encounter. Let's do this. Reviving Exhortation. Cool. Whoop. Okay, now I don't know.
Be cautious.
We might want to sneak into this place. Heritage Hill for the first time. Just a little peek. Best turn around, traveler. Heritage Hill is closed. If we're up to me, I'd burn the district. We've lost too many in there.
Good day, stranger.
The guard holds up a palm. Sorry, but this district's closed by order of the Duke himself. What's going on in there? Both guards look at each other. Look, even if I were allowed to tell you, I don't rightly know. All I can say is it, whatever it is, started about 2 months ago. The guards that closed the gate talked of something unnatural that still wakes them in the middle of the night. I don't want to know any more than that. Was there anything else? Wyla sent me. I'm looking into the missing guards. So you're the one she sent word about. The guard looks you up and down, frowning. I was expecting her to send in a whole squad of justiciars. Not that I'm volunteering, mind you. I'll have the gate opened immediately. Just watch your step. I'm afraid we can't send anyone after you if this goes badly. Heard or seen anything unusual? Friend, I try to see and hear as little as possible. One of the women on the last watch said she heard someone shouting from the northeast part of the district, something that sounded like an order. But I don't see how anyone could survive in there. Once or twice I've caught a glimpse of something moving on the other side of the gate. The guard shudders. I'd just as soon forget it. Any ideas what might have happened to the other guards? None. And I've no desire to find out, if you catch my meaning. The ones that disappeared weren't the deserting type. The worst part is, both times the watch disappeared, the next rotation found the gate unlocked. I don't know whether they went in or whether something got out, but if it's the latter, refugees are going to be the least of our problems. Farewell. And the gate's open. And Adair can level
Greetings.
Up. I see the stench hasn't driven you away yet. We're gonna level up Adair. I don't relish the thought of you populating the hill with more of those things. We're not populating with anything. We're gonna kill them. Destroy them. Athletics. Fighter abilities. Plus 20 all defenses for 15 seconds. The fighter becomes fiercely determined to deflect all incoming blows, dramatically increasing all defenses for a short time. Unbending? The fighter draws strength from his or her own indomitable spirit, causing them to regenerate 50% of endurance lost from an attack. 50% of damage taken converted to healing over time for 15 seconds. That's cool. Disciplined Barrage. Increasing accuracy. Guardian Stance. Lowers accuracy but increases the deflection of nearby allies. Clear out. Oh, nice. I like that. Sweeps the fighter's melee weapon in a large arc, knocking enemies prone, 2 per rest. Into the fray. The fighter lunges through the battle, pulling an enemy into an immediate melee range. Foe target 14 to 21 crush. Dazed for 5 seconds versus fortitude. I like this clear out. I'm going to take clear out. Okay.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
Reminds me of home, this place.
A skeletal wizard. If we clear out this place, our reputation will go up. And then we can help Durance with his thing. Look at his records about his family or something like that.
Eh?
Oh, there's a bunch. Ranger and fighter. Oh! And Ranger. Alright, let's hit this one. Okay, didn't get much of a chance to use these ranged weapons. Maybe we should have rested to help Durance. With his endurance. Yeah, yeah. Oh, they're not bunched together. We gotta wait a sec. How much does it require? 25 focus. I'm just gonna have her wait. Down. I didn't switch weapon sets? No wonder we didn't attack. Holy Radiance. Scream. Hit him here. Oh boy, it's gonna hit. Oh my god. Alright, now, cast us. We need to damage these things. I know it's already, I just want to make sure she does it. Oh yeah, we should have rested. Concussive missiles. Get this, and we can't see him. Nice. It still hit this wizard anyway, so. Oh my god. She'll be okay as long as she does that. She's the only one really hurt, so. Circle of protection. She only got a chance to cast that spell. Hello there! And you too.
Yes.
Oh, you're gonna hit ranged, okay.
That's it!
Not too bad. Bone, right? Just regular bone? Yeah. Vessel bone.
Hey.
Okay.
Hello? Hello?
Jeez, Canna. It's near. Oh, camping supplies. Awesome. Tanglefoot Trap. This trap releases a sprawling magical patch of vines and plants upon... which immediately begins to twine around the boots and legs of those standing upon it, fouling their steps. Hobbled for 3 seconds, persist reflex doesn't really do that much, but we will take it, of course. Something twitches and shambles in the darkness between the slats. A rancid draft creeps from the house. Burned lady. Alright.
Nice and quiet.
I hear something moving. Something shambling forth. What's this? Heritage Hill Cemetery. We can unlock this.
A simple test.
In this case, yes. 257 copper. These vaults have already been pried open. It's been a while since we explored stuff again. Oh my god, background messages. Why don't we close out with some background messages? If you guys want to tune out, you can tune out. See you next time in that case. Roland Gwyn, the Iron Guardian will rise again. Taryn Brackman, Mors Ultima Linea Rerum Est. Jadamalo, here lies the remains of Jadamalo, a skilled archer taken far before her time, buried with her most prized possessions, including her beloved bow, personally handcrafted, and her now empty coin purse. James W., this damn game will be the death of me. Colleen Fagan, the road goes ever on and on, down the dwarf where it began, down from the door where it began. Now, far ahead, the road is gone, and I must follow if I can. J.R.R. Tolkien. The Indare, a human male with long hair and studded leather. The writing is too weathered to read, but he appears to have been some kind of general. His title is unfamiliar, but his features seem somehow savage. Why would you picture someone in studded leather? I mean, all their life? Was he born with it on or something? Bill Willikins, a washer of ill repute of some remote inn, met an untimely demise while trying to clean. These pantaloons will be the end of me, he said, and then a wet sleeve hit him in the head. Mark Woost, I'm going to live forever. Born April 12, 1982, died April 1st, 2121. Jonathan Dota, died in service to his country at the blank of blank from a blank to the blank while attempting to blank the blank. Memorial redacted for reasons of national security. Jurik Sunsi, forever lost yet destined to return. Journeyman, blank. Mark T. Hovenkamp, I love you, Dad. I hope you're proud of me. Jeremy, it's not so long wait for the eternity. It's not a so long wait for the eternity. Kai Katani, thought he would live forever. The universe had other ideas. Kadir Cohen, never forget, death is only the beginning, especially for one of my kind. See all the K's? I would, like, J, H, J, K. It's like alphabetically here. Cadril Demath, from the band to the battalion, brothers forever. Cadril Demath, OG-18. Kyle Duran, I have lived 1,000 lives and I've loved 1,000 loved. I've walked on distant worlds and have seen the end of time, because I read. Calderanic, blank. Done. Alright. We will continue our exploration of Heritage Hill in the next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.